always do the measurement with respect to OP, either in the clock or in the anti-clockwise sense. And here, it's 30 degrees in the anti-clockwise sense. Hello everyone, this is Manas, your friend and tutor. And guys, over the past few days, I've been uploading videos on principal stress and strain. And that was completely analytical. Okay, we came across so many formulas for sigma t, for sigma n, then for the position of principal plane, for the plane of maximum shear. There were a whole lot of formulas which were derived using the basics of mechanics, and also there was a lot of trigonometry involved. And for someone like me, who is not good at memorizing, well, it becomes very difficult to remember so many formulas. Well, remembering or memorizing them is one thing, but to be able to implement them in the right perspective is another. So, in order to get out of this confusion, and in order to get rid of the analytical method, there is someone who is going to help us. And the name of that fellow, or the great fellow, is a German engineer, Otto Mohr. And this is a method which is known as the Mohr circle method, which is going to be very interesting. And the objective of this method is to help you find the value of sigma t, sigma n, find the position of principal plane, find the position of maximum shear plane, find the value of maximum shear stress completely with the help of one single diagram, which is known as the Mohr circle diagram. And today's session is going to be very interesting. What you need to remember is basic sign convention. So here it is. Let me just breeze you through all of these. So if the nature of shear stress is such, it tries to rotate the object in the anti-clockwise sign, you take this negative sign. If the nature of shear stress is such, if it tries to rotate in the anti-clockwise sense, here also, take it as negative. If it tries to rotate the object in the clockwise sense, okay, clockwise sense, you take it as positive. And here also it is going to be positive. Few more things regarding tensile and compressive stress. Here they are. This is also very interesting for tensile stress. Okay. As far as tensile stress is concerned, you have to take that as positive. And when you talk about compressive stress, you have to take that as negative. I'll try to keep this session very short, and let us try to understand this Mohr circle in depth. Here we go. Let us take this case. A very basic case, two mutually perpendicular direct stress. Now, after this video, I'll also be dealing with two mutually perpendicular direct stress combined with pure shear. Okay, that also is going to be very interesting. And if you are a gate, and if you are an aspirant of gate examination or the engineering services examination, this session is going to be very, very helpful, because after watching this entire video or these two videos which I'm about to upload on Mohr circle, you will be able to calculate the value of stresses on any plane within 10 to 15 seconds. Really, trust me, with practice, you can really develop skills to calculate the value of stresses on any plane, calculate the position of principal plane, and all of that stuff. All that calculation can be done within 10 to 15 seconds. It's going to get so very easy for all of you. But what you need to do is, you need to watch this video very sincerely right till the end. So let's take this case. So this is basically, there are two tensile stresses acting, one over this face and one over this face. Fine. So how can this Mohr circle technique help us? So here we go. Remember, first thing, you've got a horizontal line and you've got a vertical line. Horizontal line is meant for normal stress. Remember this. I want all of you guys to drill this into your mind. Horizontal line is meant for normal stress and the vertical line is meant for tangential or shear stress. Horizontal for normal stress, vertical for tangential or shear stress. Done. So we've got two normal stresses acting on two mutually perpendicular faces, one over this face, one over this face. Let's for simplicity's sake, let's say that sigma x is greater than sigma y. Okay, some assumption has to be made before explaining a concept. So with the help of a simple scale, let's say, mark sigma x. That's sigma x for you. Okay, here we go. Right? Now, since both of them are positive, so they'll be made in this positive direction of sigma. If one is positive, if one is negative, I mean, if one is tensile and the other is compressive, then for compressive, you have to work on the left hand side of this R. R, by the way, is the origin. Remember, R is the origin. For all the problems, upcoming problems, I'll be taking R as the origin. Okay, for sigma XP and for sigma Y, I'm going to put up Q. Okay, Now comes the most important aspect, especially regarding angles. Do listen and keep watching very, very carefully. Here it is. This is the face on which sigma x is acting. Okay. And this is the face on which sigma y is acting. The angle between these two faces is how much? Right? 90 degrees, isn't it? Now, if you watch carefully, if I can just locate the center of Q and P, it would be somewhere here. So this lies at a distance of sigma y, this lies at a distance of sigma x. So the center would be sigma x plus sigma y by 2. Isn't it? Right? Just think about this. Let me just erase it for a while. So that's the center. Okay. Now you can clearly see this is OP and this is OQ. The angle between is how much? 180 degrees. Okay. Sigma X is the stress on this face. Sigma X. And sigma Y is the stress on this face. That is OP and OQ. Both of them here are making an angle of 180 degrees. And in the configuration diagram, this, by the way, for the entire session, I'll be referring to as the configuration diagram. In the configuration diagram, the angle in between these two faces, where sigma X is acting and where sigma Y is acting, is 90 degrees. Whereas in the Mohr circle, it becomes double. That means it becomes 180 degrees. So here it is. One more rule which you need to remember. In the configuration diagram, if a particular angle is represented by theta, then in the corresponding Mohr circle diagram, it has to be represented by double of that. Let's say 2 theta. Okay. Now, you could have argued that, sir, here this plane that which you have set up is obviously making an angle theta, but in the anti-clockwise sense with the vertical. Okay. It would have made a clockwise angle also. It would have been something like this also. Right? Isn't it? Angle could have been like this also. That also is absolutely correct. Yes, I'm going to take that case up also. Don't worry. All of this is going to be worked out in a very in-depth fashion. Okay, so let's take this session forward a bit slowly and then we'll gradually speed up. Okay, so that's 90 here and here it becomes 180. So any angle in the configuration diagram, let's say it's theta, it becomes 2 theta doubled in the corresponding Mohr circle diagram. Now what to do? This angle is with respect to this sigma x, with respect to this P. Okay, here the angle made is theta. So here the angle made is going to be 2 theta, right? Something like this. Let me just mark it. So first of all, you need to do this. Okay, make the circle and then make the angle. Let me show that once again. With OP as the radius, make this Mohr circle. Once you have O, once you have P, then make the Mohr circle, right? And with respect to P, give it a turn by an angle of 2 theta. There you go. And that's going to be point T. Drop a perpendicular from T onto this horizontal, that is 2 theta by the way. This is going to give you a specific point. The name of this point is S. For now, just write this, that is S. Join T with R, that is also going to give you something. And by the way, this is going to be your sigma n. Sigma n is the normal stress. Okay, I'll show it to you, don't worry. This over here is sigma T and this is sigma R. Once again. Okay, so what we did, we located the center, fine, and with OP as the radius, we drew a circle, and this is the Mohr circle. Okay, now what we need to do is, we need to find the normal stress, that is sigma n, this way, sigma n, and the tangential stress along this plane. Let's say that the name of the plane is AB. This over here is sigma t. How do you do that? This plane is making an angle of theta in the configuration diagram. Therefore, it is going to make an angle of 2 theta in the Mohr circle diagram. Here, it was making an angle with this face. And this face is OP, or simply P you can say in the Mohr circle. Okay. So from with respect to this P, the angle made over here is going to be 2 theta. Let me just show you. This point has been marked as T. Drop a perpendicular from T. This point, let's say, is represented by S. then RS, this distance RS is going to give you the value of normal stress. Okay, this over here, this TS, if we just write this, sigma n is going to be equal to this length RS. Sigma T, by the way, is going to be equal to the length TS, and sigma R, the resultant stress, is going to be equal to RT. You'll see that. That's RT. Done. This angle over here is going to be represented by, let's say, phi. And phi basically is the resultant, okay? And you can also say that sigma R is basically equal to, well, with this is basic Pythagorean theorem, sigma n square plus sigma t square. How can you implement this for a particular problem? Let's see that. And that's going to be very interesting. If you have seen the video till here, it's going to be very easy for you. Here we go. So this is the first problem, example one. So what you need to do is you need to find the value of sigma n and sigma t on this plane, okay, at an angle of 30 degree. And this is in the anti-clockwise sense. So in the Mohr circle also, this anti-clockwise sense has to be followed. Okay, fine. Let's have the coordinate axis. Sigma for normal stresses and tau for shear stresses. First of all, let me fix this 160 first. Both these stresses are tensile, so they'll be in the positive side of R. That's for sure. Okay, that's 100. Right? Let's say you need to take a scale over here, guys. Let's say 10 mm represents how much? 100 MPa. If 10 mm represents 100 MPa, then the 60 MPa will be represented by a line of 10 millimeters. So from here, at a distance of 60 millimeters, you need to mark this point Q. Done. Okay, that's 60 MPa, right? You need to mark the center. Okay, this is very easy. So with the OPS radius, make this circle. That's the Mohr circle. Now you need to mark this point T. Okay, so the angle over here is 30 degrees. So it will be doubled. That is 2 theta. That is 60 degrees with respect to this P over here. Okay, here we go. 60 degrees. This angle, let me just show you, 2 theta. And 2 theta, by the way, is 60 degree. Drop a perpendicular from T. This is going to give you S. And TS, by the way, is sigma T. And TR is going to give you sigma R. And RS is going to give you, well, this is 90 megapascals. If you use this scale, the length from R to S, okay, let me just write it over here. The length from R to S will work out as how much? 90 mm. That's quite true. And when you do the conversion, it will be 90 MPa. This is how we actually assess the problems. And then secondly, with this is going to work out as 17. Roughly, you cannot get this decimal value. Okay, with the help of a pencil and scale, you cannot get this value. So I initially did this on an AutoCAD, and that's why I have got this accurate value. Okay, so sigma T will work out as, if you use a pencil and scale, it is going to work out as 17 millimeters roughly, or 18 millimeters, let's say. Okay, so that's it. And this is going to be what, this is TS. So TS will work out as roughly 17 millimeters. And on conversion, this will become 17 MPa. It's that simple. And in the same manner, you can have this. This is your resultant. Okay, and there you go. Let me just show that once again. And I forgot to mention this angle. Okay, don't worry. Second case, as I told you, there are two mutually perpendicular tensile stresses and the angle measured with the vertical was anti-clockwise or counterclockwise. But here, the angle measured is going to be in the clockwise sense. Let's see if there is any change in the values of sigma t, sigma n and sigma r obtained. Yes or no? Let's check that out. Okay, so here we go. First of all, sigma x. What we are assuming? Sigma x greater than sigma y. Sigma x and this is sigma y. Both of them positive. Why? They are tensile. Locate the center with OPS radius. Draw the circle. That's the Mohr circle. Okay. Now, the angle measured always from OP. Always from OP. Remember this, clock or anti-clock, you have to decide that. And here, the angle made is in the clockwise sense with the vertical, with this face over here. Okay, so 2 theta, do 2 theta, with respect to this, you have to go 2 theta. So this, by the way, have I written 2 theta or not? Okay, I need to write it. So this is going to be 2 theta. Okay, so drop a perpendicular from T onto this horizontal line. I had written it. Erase that. So that's going to be point S for you. Done. So this, by the way, this RS is going to give you sigma n. This ST is going to give you sigma T. And this TR is going to give you sigma R. It's that simple. Okay. Now let us try to implement the same thing with the help of a problem. Okay. Let's take a very basic case. The same problem, in fact. The only difference being that the angle measured is going to be clockwise with the vertical. Let's see that. Same case. So let's start. Here we go. And watch this. Both. Let me just mark them. 100. And this is 60. Okay. This is 60 millimeters. This is 100 millimeters, by the way. Right. If you are drawing this to scale, that's exactly what you need to do. Okay. Locate the center and draw the Mohr circle. Now, this angle is how much? This is 30 degrees. So, double of that, that is 60 degrees, but in the clockwise sense. Always with respect to OP. With respect to OP. 60 degrees. This is going to be how much? 60 degrees. Right? And that's going to be point S for you. Okay? And by the way, RS is going to represent the normal stress. Normal stress like this. Value of normal stress on this plane. That is RS. And as far as shear stress is concerned, or the tangential stress will be along the plane, that is sigma t. First of all, let me just show you the normal stress. That's normal stress. And over here we have sigma. How much is this? 17.32. Again, you've got the same value, but here you've got a negative value. That's the only difference. That means this is compressive and this is tensile. That's it. And again, this is sigma r, and that's angle phi made. Done. Very basic. Let us take this session forward and let me slightly change the problem. Let's have one force, not force, let's have one stress as tensile and the other as compressive. And we'll keep on changing the combination. Okay. And by the end of this video, you guys will be in a very nice position to solve and crack problems in 10 to 15 seconds. Literally. This can be done with simple pen and paper. You don't even need to have a rounder, compass or protractor like that. You can simply do this roughly. Okay. And use a bit of Pythagoras theorem. And that's it. You can solve any problem and Mohr circle very easily. And do watch the next video also. That is going to be very important because that is a combined case. Two mutually perpendicular stresses plus shear stress. Here we go. Next example. So for the given configuration. Okay. So again, the angle measured is in the counterclockwise sense and it has been specified. If it was specified in the question that you need to do the calculation for a clockwise measured angle, then do that in that sense. No problem. But here we have been clearly specified that we need to measure the value of sigma n and sigma t on the plane at an angle of 30 degrees with the vertical in the counterclockwise direction. That is anti-clockwise direction. Let's do this. Green, tensile. Red, compressive. Let's have the coordinate axis. This is the origin. Always 100. The scale is going to remain same. 10 mm is 10 MPa. Remember, 10 mm is 10 MPa. So I'll have 10 mm divisions over here. Something like this. Okay. Do this roughly. You don't really need a scale. You need a scale, but you don't need a rounder or protractor or anything like that. You can do that very easily. So 100 MPa is positive. Okay. It's green, tensile. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, 100. Mark 100 over here. Done. Point P done. 60. This is red. That is compressive. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Okay. In the negative sense, that's 60 for you. Now you need to locate the center. So this over here is 100. This is 60. So half of 100 plus 60 is 160. Half of 160 is 80. So this is from here. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80. So this is the center. Mark the center. And with OP as the radius, make the Mohr circle. Here it is. Done. You need to find the point. Okay. So there is going to be a point T on the periphery of the circle. Here. always do the measurement with respect to OP, either in the clock or in the anti-clockwise sense. And here, it's 30 degrees in the anti-clockwise sense. So in the Mohr diagram, it will be 60 degrees, double in the anti-clockwise sense with respect to OP. Do that. Here we go. That's it. This is exactly what I was intending to do. That's 60 degrees for you. Okay. Instead, let me just write 2 theta over here. That's 2 theta. And by the way, this is theta is equal to 30 degrees. What we are finding is normal stress across this plane. And here also. This is tangential stress along the plane, by the way. Okay. Now, drop a perpendicular from T on this horizontal. That's going to be point S. Okay. This is point S. And join T with R. So this, let me just calculate the values, or I've already calculated the values. Let me just show them to you what they are going to work out as. And first of all, sigma n, this is going to be sigma n from R to S, isn't it? If you just try to calculate it roughly, this is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. So sigma n will work out as 60 millimeters. When you do the conversion, 60 millimeter is 60 megapascals. It's that simple. And similarly, you can work this out also. Let me just show you what the final answer is. RS is 60 millimeters, 60 MPa. Sigma T, this is sigma T by the way, TS, 69.28 mm. Don't worry, you cannot get this decimal value 69.28. You will get it somewhere around 68, 69 or 70 even. So write that rough answer, okay? You are going to get an approximate value with the help of Mohr circle and not an exact value. So don't ponder upon it. That's 69.28 and what else? Here the angle made is phi. This is sigma r. This, by the way, is sigma t, and this between r and s, that is sigma n. We already know that. Sigma r is the resultant of sigma n and sigma t. Okay, that is 91.65. In Pascal also it is 91.65. And finally, phi will work out as 49 degrees. Isn't that easy? Isn't that easy? Now let's increase the pace with which we are working them out. Here we go. Next problem. So here we go. This time around, this 100, this is compressive and this 60 is tensile. Very interesting. Let's have the axis. Okay. So these are all 10 millimeter divisions. So each division is 10 megapascals. Right? 100. So this is compressive. So it will be marked over here towards the left of origin. And 60, this is tensile. So it will be marked towards the right of R. That's 100. That's 60. Done. The center will be somewhere here. This totality, this is 160. Half of 160 is 80, so it will be somewhere here. That's O. With OP as the radius, draw the circle. You've got the Mohr circle now. You need to find T. Where is T? This is 30. So, in the anti-clockwise sense, okay, so here it is going to be twice of that, that is 60. Again, in the anti-clockwise sense. But always with respect to OP. Always with respect to OP. Okay. This is 60 degrees and this point is point T. Done. From T, drop a perpendicular on this horizontal line. That's going to be point S and join it with R also. So this, by the way, this is your phi. This is sigma T. This over here will give you sigma what? Sigma N. And this, by the way, this is sigma R. It's that simple. If you want to do a measurement, these are the values which you are going to be getting. Minus 60, why? Because it is towards the left of origin, okay? Minus 69 because it is in the downward direction. And that's it, that's it. These are the values which you are going to be getting. You can tally them, try to solve them also. Once you watch these videos, try to note these problems down and individually and try to solve all of them and try to match whether your answers are correct or not. Okay, let's take the final case up. Okay, so this is, both of them are compressive, red, danger. Okay, let's have the coordinate axis. This is the origin and let me have the 10 megapascal divisions, 160. So 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, that's 100 P. Okay, that is sigma X. Then 60, this is going to be 60. Center is going to be here. With OP as radius, draw the circle. Very easy, isn't it? Again, anti-clockwise 30 degrees. Here it is going to be 60 degrees anti-clockwise with respect to always PQ. So not PQ but OP. Okay. Anti-clockwise. How much? This is 60 degrees. By the way, 2 theta. You've got point T. From T, drop a perpendicular over here. That's going to be point S. T with Q. Not Q, what am I saying? It's T with R. Always join T with R. You drop a perpendicular and then join T with R. This over here is going to give you sigma n. Okay, let me just erase that for a while. So the final values are here it is. If you just try to count this 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. That is RS. RS is 90. In the negative direction, that's why you have put up this sign. So it is compressive in nature. That is the final comment you can make. Sigma T is also in the downward direction. This is also going to work out in the compressive sense. That's it. And sigma R, this is by the way sigma R. There you go. And finally, phi. This is over here is phi. Value of phi obtained is 11 degrees. So guys, after watching this entire video, I am very much sure that you can easily tackle problems for two mutually perpendicular stress. Do watch the next video also, as there I'm going to pick up the combination, that is two mutually perpendicular stresses plus shear stress. That is the final case on which I am going to be making a video, and that is going to be released very, very soon. Don't worry. So guys, that was all for today. I'll see you again in the next video. Until then, take care. Have a nice day. Keep learning. Keep watching. Thanks.